If you only knew the power of the dark side.
Welcome back to the channel. It is the baddest man on the planet, the human juggernaut himself, Damian McLeod. Now, in light of the recent exposure of, I was about to say, Anabolic Destiny, Alpha Destiny,
right?
You know, people are asking my opinion. I see a lot of hate. You know, I did a video on the Alpha Destiny fanboys hating, you know. Shout out to those nerds. But my real thing, you know, what people have been asking me, what do you feel about David Lade and his supposed gyno, alleged gyno from allegedly taking things, right? I did a video on this a while back and I kept it real as hell. If you guys want to see it, go back. It's not too far in. But it just so happens that today they posted a video with, it was McKenna, Dylan McKenna and David Lade, one of those really flat, dry, guilty-ish feeling Q&As, you know, it just felt really guilty, you know. One of the things, I want to bring out a few things, I'll make this quick. So, one of the things that Alpha Destiny, David Lade, and Dylan McKenna have in common, in my opinion, is the whole stigma around everyone believing they're fake natties. You know, myself included. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I've been in this game for a long time. I've been lifting weights for a really, really, really long time. And I know what it takes to get gains, to hit these PRs. You know what I'm saying? I know the work it takes to, you know, to do these things. So when I see people just, you know, program. These guys start this video off with, oh, well, your program. You know, they always keep that, you know, it's propaganda. They keep that program talk out there so that people think, you know, what this person said, you know, 4 sets of this versus this person says 6 sets. This person does drop sets. You know, this person only works out these days of the week. So, you know, one of these different ideas is going to give me these maximal gains like these guys get. When in reality, that's just not true. What these guys have in common is the fact that allegedly the people believe they're fake natties. I'm just not going to sugarcoat anymore. I never have. You know, it's not about the program. Like I said, all my gains, me benching 325, when I was like, you know, really, really in, where I'm actually going to get back to, because actually I've been nursing a left torn rear delt, so I can't hit it right now, but actually it's feeling better, so I probably, you know, I'm going to get it back up. You know me, I'm the Alpha Wolf. But, you know, going through the grind and then years and training, it's just the things these guys are doing, they're ridiculous. We already know Alpha Destiny with the fake overhead 225 press and then the fraudulent Jefferson lift, you know, and then David Lade with the, you know, all of a sudden he's, 1 minute he's struggling on, what, 225, 230, all of a sudden he's hitting, what, 30, it's just ridiculous. You know, they're hitting in the 300s. It's ridiculous with 395 or something on the max bench, and this is all in a couple of months. And then they come on with videos like this talking about how they don't eat, their training is shit all the time. How many times have you heard these guys say, oh, my training is just so shit and not focused and all these excuses, yet they come in every so often and hit these crazy ass PRs. You know what I'm saying? It's a bunch of fraudulence. And the fact that, you know, if you want to be a fan of the person, goddamn, hold on. Shit. If you want to be a fan of the person, you know, that's fine. But, you know that these people you idolize, they're not entirely honorable in their agenda. At the end of the day, it's all about, you know, getting on social media, getting a big following, you know, getting your D-riders, getting your money from your D-riders, and buying fancy cars, just like every one of them does. At the end of the day, it's not really about you. You gotta understand that. It's not about you. They're doing it for them. Now, there's nothing wrong with having a fitness business, you know what I'm saying? But it's all about the person being legit. Once you start to notice, you start to take a whiff of fraudulence in the air? You know, it starts to make you wonder, you know what I'm saying? Now, David Lade had pointed out, you know, oh, everyone's asking why hasn't he made videos in so long? And let's face it, you know, the pictures came out with him, you know, with gyno on the nipples. So you would think, well, a person, you know, is getting surgery to get these things fixed. They're going in, you know, you got to go and get surgery. You can't, I don't know, unless there's some pills you can take maybe to make the shit subside. I don't know. I've never had the shit. But the only way I've heard to get rid of it is to go get surgery. So, you know, that would be kind of, you know, my opinion. What other people are saying, you know, why he hasn't been making a lot of videos like that. I haven't really watched a bunch of his videos. I don't know if he's had any videos with his shirt off. If not, you know, over the last month or two, if he hasn't been putting videos with his shirt off, other than those pictures where people were pointing out the gyno, chances are, you know, either he's, you know, it's some shit going on. You know what the fuck I'm saying? I'm trying not to slander, because I don't want to slander anybody. You know, at the end of the day, it's not me hating these guys. I don't hate any of them. It's just that when you see people in the fitness industry, Alpha Destiny, Ahmad Ogus, Aquino Body, you know, the obvious frauds, you know, it really makes you want to just put that shit on blast. It's not the hate at all. It's just that, you know, a real person, when you're honorable in your intentions, you can't just sit back and say, well, I'm gonna do me and let them guys do them. No, you know, if you saw some wrong being done out there in the world, you know, you're not just gonna walk past a guy beating up his wife in the middle of the fucking street in public and just, you know, not go and help out just because, well, you know, I'm gonna do me. You know, some people actually do that, and that's cowardly as fuck. But an honorable person, a non-cowardly person, an alpha male, you're gonna do something about it. You're gonna walk over there, you're gonna, you know, punch the guy, knock him the fuck out. You know, in this situation here, you're not just gonna ignore the fraudulence to your left. You know, you're not gonna ignore the weirdo in the room, you know what I'm saying? Or you might end up getting assaulted. You know, you're gonna step up, you're gonna do something. You're gonna say something, do whatever you can do. You know, and with all I can do right now, just put the shit on blast. You know what I'm saying? Hope as many people see it as possible. It's not hating at all. You know what I'm saying? It's just having the testicular fortitude to say something when it needs to be said. And a lot of people don't have that, because they have hopes of, oh, I'll ruin a collab with these guys one day. You know, maybe one day David Lade and McKenna, they might collab with me. You know, so I'll turn a blind eye to the fraudulence I'm smelling. You know, that's weakness. Who cares about a collab with someone who's a fraud? Because then now you're in the fraud department. You know, be your own man, do your own thing. You know what I'm saying? I see these fanboys just kissing ass, and these, you know, I seen a couple of people come in. Like this one guy, he posted a comment on this fraudulent shit. And let me go down. This where'd it go? This Domingo guy, he goes, he's losing his hair because of Royce. Because some said, why he's always wearing a beanie? Like, who cares why he's wearing a beanie? You know what I'm saying? But this guy, clearly, you know, he's, maybe because he's losing his hair for Royce. 25 likes on that comment. You know, because a lot of people believe, you know, these guys are frauds. They might not always post a comment, but they'll like on a comment that, you know, sways in the favor of their beliefs. Like, this dude bald. Like, you know what I'm saying? Not to hate on him, because if he's going bald, whatever, that is what it is. Everybody does it at some point. But the thing is, you know, watching this video, you can just see, like, there's something there. You know, they talk about, you know, having ADHD, why he hasn't posted videos. There's all these excuses. ADHD, it has nothing to do with a person not posting a video. You're going to be doing some sort of action, you know. If you're not going to be making videos, but you're doing something, you're not just standing in the corner all day looking at the wall. It's a conscious choice to not do something. I can sit there and say, well, I'm not going to do this all day. It's a conscious choice. It's not because I have ADHD and I'm doing something else. Like, no, you know, you just, it's, come on. This is, it's people. It's Friday. But, you know, like in this video, you know, everyone's saying, oh, he looks emotionless. He looks flat, you know. And, you know, yeah, you know, I'm fucking sad too. I had to go get my nipples chopped off. Like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? And the other guy, Dylan McKenna, you know, like I've said, this guy, his muscle progress was just too fucking erratic. It was just too fucking quick. I remember when he first jumped on the scene with David Lade. He started being in his videos, and he was, you know, he was really, really, really scrawny. And it's weird because he also said, well, back in high school, we thought we were small, but we were actually bigger than most. No, you weren't. Like, just recently, I saw you in, you know, I saw some recent videos, not recent videos, but when you first kind of got on, you were scrawny as shit. It was a video. They were, like, in his mom's house, like, in this big basement area in their house, and he had this little tank top on. It was really frail. Now, all of a sudden, look at him. His arms are fucking thick and meaty looking. He has some body fat on him, but that's, you know, that's just off cycle. You know what I'm saying? I mean, on cycle, bulking up type of look. That's the look that is, you know, if he's actually doing it. I don't know. I've never seen any of these guys do anything, you know. Allegedly, the people believe. And that's why I'm making this video. So, you know, like I said, people, I don't want to drag this shit out. But, you know, there's a lot of fraudulence going on, you know, especially on the Alpha Destiny side of the game on these guys. Like I said, the Matt Ogus era, Fake Natty. You know what I'm saying? Now, this is Fake Natty era 2.0. There's always a new group of 20-year-olds stepping out of the gates trying to deceive people. And you can just look at a person, whether you're a fan of the person or not. When I first saw David Lade's videos, I was watching this shit. I was like, oh, look at this dude. He's cool, man. He reminds me of Jeff Saeed, but a natural version. Because he actually looked like, you know, he had his physique naturally. He was lean. He wasn't overly muscular. He wasn't lifting at enormously heavy weights for his size. And then all of a sudden, he just blows in with 300-something, like, what was it, 390-pound bench press, almost 400 pounds? Like, what the fuck? And then all of a sudden, he has this gyno look on his nipples. It's like, okay. Well, they're in the game now. And this guy here, you know, went from scrawny to big. And, you know, like they say, well, it's not programming. It's something else entirely. But that's all I want to say for this video, just get my opinion. You guys seem to like my opinion. I'm going to keep these videos coming. I'll get back to the fight videos. I have a ton of fight videos filmed, but you got to get the people what they want. And then I'll ease in with some shit. Of course, I'm going to do some cool bench, some cool push-up videos I've been working on. Like, my push-up game is ridiculous right now. That's all I've been doing, because I really don't want to just go into the gym prematurely and jack up my shoulder again. It feels good, but, you know, being in this game from experience, you got to give yourself that proper rest. So I feel safe hitting these push-ups. I don't feel safe going in, throwing on the 225, the 245, the 255, the 275, throwing up those reps right now. I just don't want to aggravate. I want to let the muscles heal really, really well. So don't worry. I'm not going anywhere. But if you haven't already done so, if you like the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. I'm subliminally in your mind. So until next time, get to the gym, do work, muscle up. My adversaries cry like hoes, fully eradicate my foes. My lyrics explode on contact, came in you hoes. Who else but mama's only son? But the phony